And welcome to my channel. Today I've got a New Year's Eve inspired look for you, but actually it's... Well, basically this was more of a New Year's Eve inspired look, but you could just use it for any occasion really where you want to do glam makeup, but you do still want to be able to remove it easily. Because that's basically what my goal in mind was, like something that looks really glam, but that you don't have to like spend 12 hours scrubbing off in the middle of the night after the festivities. So yeah, and also just wanted to chat about the past year, the next year, just, you know, have a nice talk. So yeah, let's get on to it. Now, contrary to usual, I'm actually starting off with a, well, two BB creams actually. Because I feel like, you know, on New Year's Eve, you usually stay up late, you know, to actually say Happy New Year to friends and family. Maybe through your phone or whatever this year, but you know, you're not going to go to bed early as usually. And I find it very important, it is very important for your skin and for skincare properties and all. For the health of your skin overall to remove your makeup before going to bed. And I'd rather apply a light layer of makeup and then take off a light layer of makeup than to condemn myself to having to remove like this huge thick cake layer of makeup at like 2 in the morning, because that's just not something I enjoy. So yeah, I'm keeping it light. Then straight on to eye primer, because, you know, if I fall out now and, you know, we don't need the BB cream on, I can still just blend it again, just remove the fallout, blend again, and we'll be fine, which would not be the case if I were to, like, go full in with, like, all kinds of other stuff, like powder. Okay, preparations are done, so I'm just gonna pull you closer for the eyes. This is going to be the first step, and it's going to be very easy, because, well, basically, I don't want to do an eyeliner, because an eyeliner is annoying to remove in the middle of the freaking night, or very early in the morning. So instead, I'm going to use my favorite technique with the other brush, putting it in against my eye, and then just very carefully, because I don't want buckets to fall out, just dabbing this onto my eyelids. And I'm really applying layers, because I want this to be as dark as possible. Because this is probably just going to be it for the eyeliner. I don't think I'm going to apply any actual eyeliner, because again, I don't feel like having to remove that later on at night. And yeah, then I'm just going to blend this, and black is quite a difficult color to blend out, especially considering we didn't really put anything beneath it. So just take your time with this, because if this is properly blended already, then every other step is just going to go a lot smoother. Now, we're gonna work on blending it a little bit further. For that, I'm going to use one of my favorite palettes of this year, I think. I don't know if it came out this year, but I bought it this year at any rate. The Naked Ultraviolet Palette by Urban Decay. If you don't have this, just use similar colors as the ones I'm going to use, and you'll be fine as well. But yeah, I'm going to start with the taupe shades on a more dense blending brush, and I'm just going to deepen up the crease in the front part of the eye and just, you know, make the whole thing a little bit more skin toned rather than grey. Yeah. By the way, if you want to chat along about your New Year's plans, please do so in the comment section, because it's always fun. But me personally, I'm going to just spend it with my parents. Basically, my goal for next year is find a full-time job so I can live on my own. But for this year, I still live with my parents, and that's just as well, because that means, you know, we're one household, so we can just spend it together. Without having to keep distance, which is kind of nice. So we're just going to probably do the same thing as we do every single year. We're probably going to do, I don't know if they know this in other countries, but it's like, it's called gourmet, but not like the whole fancy dishes, but more like there's this thing on the table with like, where you can put a lot of tiny pans on, and then you can all just make your own, little food thing, like basically just, you know, cook your own meat. It sounds so random, but it's a lot of fun, and it has a plus that it takes quite a lot of time. Because I always feel like I don't have any issues staying up late when it's like just me and I'm just watching YouTube videos or whatever. I just dropped the brush. But anyway, I don't have issues staying up late then. But if you're like with family or with friends or whatever, and then you like have to stay up, like on New Year's Eve when you have to stay up until midnight, I don't know, it's more easy to get bored somehow, because then you have to. Like, it's easier to stay up when you actually should go to bed than when you want to stay up. Anyway, shimmery brow on highlight, by the way. But anyways, and yeah, like eating like that just takes a lot more time than normal eating. So it's just, it takes more time and that's good on New Year's Eve. We also usually end up doing games like Monopoly or Schule. Schule is another Dutch thing. You basically have this like large wooden plank with like sides and there's like four holes in the back. And there's these like sort of like hockey pucks, but like made of wood that you have to like push forward, like, just like show forward, like sort of like bowling, but like with tinier things. It's, go Google it. That's probably better than my explanation, but it's a lot of fun. And I also discovered that way a few years ago that when I'm slightly tipsy and also not wearing glasses or contact lenses, I can actually aim really well. I can aim, but only when I can't see what I'm aiming at. I'm not sure if that's useless or useful, but still. Anyway, so yeah, this is usually a lot of fun. For the eyelid, we're just going to go for funky, sort of. I'm going to go into a almost glowing green shade. White-ish green. And what I always like to do when I want to go for fancy, but I don't want to go for 20 layers, is just apply a shimmer shade, sort of like a fading out cut crease thing. But without actually properly cutting the crease, like without putting primer there first and all, but just going in and just, you know, having faith in the eyeshadow itself. But yeah, one thing in the Netherlands, by the way, that's different than other years, is this year you're not allowed to light fireworks yourself. Which honestly, I'm not mad about. Because quite frankly, I always found it a bit odd that on New Year's Eve, like people who have absolutely no experience with explosives are allowed to light explosives. While probably half of them is like drunk. So, you know, it's kind of dangerous and like animals get scared from it. And I also find it highly ironic that the rest of the year we hear all this thing, all these things about the environment and keeping the air clean. But on New Year's Eve, there's like heaps of crap being shot into the air, which is also not good for the environment. Going into a darker brown shade with green shimmer on a blending brush. But anyway. And also, and that's for me the main thing, like the next day you always hear there's like tens of millions of damage from the fireworks. And I'm like, if we can't do it in a fun way, then let's just not do it at all. Because seriously, that's just like, I don't see how that's a fun way to like start a new year, you know, by destroying public property. Like seriously, or private property for that matter. So yeah, I'm not mad about the lack of fireworks this year. Also because I personally just don't really like sudden loud noises going into an even darker shimmer shade. Like I do understand for people who really enjoy fireworks that it sucks. But like I do feel with like the whole environment thing and all that it is something we probably should get used to. That will just end at some point. You know, probably be replaced by drones because they're a lot better for the environment. So yeah. I mean, that's an interesting discussion, not one I'm really particularly interested in, like, participating in. But anyway, I'll just enjoy this year of, like, being able to celebrate New Year's Eve without earplugs in. To make it a little bit more, I hope you can tell, just catching. Just putting a little bit of the black eyeshadow just in that inner corner. Where I would normally put eyeliner, but instead of eyeliner, I'm using this on a very, very thin brush. Then onto some concealer. I'm mostly just applying this beneath my eyes. But yeah, and also, instead of only focusing on the new year, let's talk about the old year as well, because it's been a year. I feel like it's a bit of a weird year in terms of that. Like, I feel like there's people for who this year was completely dreadful and, you know, extremely out of the ordinary, and people for who life just basically mostly continued as usual. I myself fall into that last category. I gotta say, my life this year has not been very much different than other years. For me, it's actually, for example, just been a bit busier at work, actually. So, I consider myself very lucky with that. Like, I can imagine for people who, like, work in, like, entertainment business and, like, tourism, restaurants and stuff, that it was a very, very crappy year. Oh, and that's, of course, I have powder all over my trousers now, anyway. And that's, of course, only considering, like, the financial aspect. Of course, it's way worse if you actually, you know, in terms of health or your family's and friends' health, actually had a lot of issues with the situation. Like, Besides, I'm lucky too. No one I know got seriously, seriously ill, so that's good. And me, myself, neither. So yeah, that's another thing. I do feel like this was a bit of a, I don't know, a boring year in the sense of, for me personally at least, I don't feel like right now I'm at a different spot in my life than I was at the beginning of this year or the end of last year. So yeah, I do really want to work on, like I said before, on finding a full-time job and actually moving out of my parents' house next year. Like, to just actually get on with life personally. Now I'm just doing a light contour with obviously a light contouring powder. But anyway, so those are my own personal plans for the future, which if you're interested, you can follow all of that on my vlogs as well. I post a vlog once every 3 weeks on my channel. In which obviously I also mention that sort of stuff. And in general, I just hope that, you know, with the vaccine and all, I don't know how to pronounce it in English. But anyway, I really hope that we'll be able to go to concerts again and go to theme parks and go shopping with friends and just in general don't have to keep distance from each other anymore. Because I kind of miss being around a lot of people. Onto a matte peachy blush, because that fits with anything. But yeah, as an introverted person, I really just did not expect that actually. Like, I didn't expect missing it to be around a lot of other people at the same time. But I don't know, it's just a different vibe if you're sitting in a full cinema or like watching a concert with heaps of other people than if you're basically there in terms of concerts, not at all, and in terms of the cinema with like a handful of other people spread out over the room and you're basically still sort of alone there. I don't know, it's a bit more boring, I guess. Then on to a highlight, sort of an icy blue shade. But yeah, anyway, historically, every pandemic ends sometime. And, you know, I do feel like now we do have the plus of living in the 21st century, where we know a lot of things about health and healthcare and, like, vaccines and, like, I don't know, the whole medical science, of course, is a lot better than, like, 100 years ago or, like, even, I don't know, 200 or 500 years ago, obviously. In general, of course, like me personally, I have no medical knowledge whatsoever. But, you know, I do think in that aspect we're very lucky that we live in this day and age and not 100 years ago. Then for the under eye, I'm not even going to pull you closer because it's very easy, actually. I'm just going to go in with the matte brown shade, the taupe shade that also applied in the inner corner of the crease. And just smudge that beneath my eye. And then just blend it out with a blending brush without product on it. Just so the bottom becomes a little bit smoky, but nothing too much. Like so. Next up, eye pencil. Instead of black, I'm actually going for a deep burgundy purple-ish shade. Because it looks a little bit softer, I guess. But yeah, anyway. And also next year, I just really hope we can travel again. Because I really want to go back to Berlin. I want to go to London. I just want to travel a lot. But yeah, like, but seriously though, my main focus, like my number one priority, the first thing I'm going to focus on, is getting a full-time job. That's like literally the most important thing. Another thing I really enjoy when I just really want to hurriedly take my makeup off is not having to wipe off 10 gallons of mascara. So instead of using a lot of mascara, I'm instead going to use falsies. And I am going to use a pair that has a clear lash band because I'm not wearing any eyeliner. So yeah, this is the before and the after. As you can hopefully tell, it just makes the entire thing a lot more glam and done up, I feel. Like, I don't know, a lot more fancy. If you are not tinting your eyelashes or have black eyelashes by nature, you could also just apply some mascara. I'm not going to because I tint my eyelashes so they're already black, so I'm fine with how they are now. But it's an option. Anyway, so now all that's left to do is lip setting spray, and I also almost forgot to do my eyebrows. So I'm gonna do those first. I'm gonna keep them quite simple, and also let me tell you a little secret. I am really, really into skincare. I find it very important to do skincare well and to remove makeup properly. But the one exception to that is literally my eyebrows. Like, not in terms of like tweezing them, I do that. But in terms of like removing product off them. Basically, if there's one part of my makeup that I'm not going to bother removing properly, it's going to be the eyebrow product. Because, I don't know, like on my eyeballs, that just sounds so creepy and wrong. On my eyelids, I remove my makeup really well and below them because I don't want to give myself wrinkles. On my face, on my skin, I remove it really well because I don't want to get zits. But on my eyebrows, it's like, I don't typically get zits on my eyebrows or wrinkles on my eyebrows. So, I don't know, like, I'm the sort of person who sometimes will, in fact, just not properly remove eyebrow product just so I don't have to bother reapplying it fully the next day. Which sort of sounds like a crime against skincare, but on the other hand, it's eyebrows, so I don't really feel like the skin beneath my eyebrow hairs actually cares. Then some setting spray. Okay, then lastly the lips. I'm going to do those in a nude shade because, one of the reasons is actually because of eating, because if I want to be able to eat all evening, then I don't want to have to worry about my lipstick. And if a nude shade fades off, then you won't really be able to tell all that much. And also, a red lipstick or any deep color might stain the lips and you really have to rub to get it off. With a nude, you don't have that issue at all, so that's also a plus. And here we have the final results. I gotta say, this lipstick, for some reason, it's Celebrity Skin by Jeffree Star. It always gives me massive 90s vibes and I'm loving it. But anyway, I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my videos, please subscribe to my channel. Also, if you want to chat along about all the subjects I talked about, please do so. Although, you know, always keep things friendly. I know a lot of people, at least here in the Netherlands, are really passionately either against or for fireworks. Just, you know, keep an open mind and be polite about each other's opinions. So yeah, and that was basically it for today. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!